To fulfill that multiple use mission, it's essential that the Bureau gather information to determine ecosystem condition and how those conditions are changing over time. The knowledge or monitoring information is necessary to guide and justify land uses, policy action, and adaptive management decisions. The BLM Assessment Inventory and Monitoring Strategy is designed to provide this information. So the goal of the Assessment Inventory and Monitoring Strategy is to reach across BLM programs, jurisdictions, stakeholders, and agencies to provide key information for decision makers that can be collected once and used many times. Early on, it was recognized that we need this information at multiple scales. Another thing that was recognized is that we can't do this alone. And this is probably really one of the initial ventures into the landscape approach, which has now become one of the secretarial priorities.
The first principle of AIM is to collect information on standard quantitative indicators of ecosystem functioning. Basically, that just means we're all collecting the same information in the same way. And what that enables is easy comparison of data collected across different programs within BLM, across different agencies, in different locations, and over time. To date, we have identified core quantitative indicators for terrestrial ecosystems and for aquatic ecosystems. The second principle of AIM is to use a statistically valid, scalable monitoring sample design. And basically, that's just a systematic way of choosing where to locate your sample points across a landscape. The benefit of doing that is that you can collect data once, but use it many times for many, many different purposes, from informing an individual grazing allotment conditions, to regional conditions, to a national assessment of BLM lands.
The third principle of AIM is that on-the-ground monitoring should be integrated with remote sensing, which in of itself is inherently multi-scale. Remote sensing data can be captured from simple digital cameras on the ground all the way up to satellites orbiting the Earth. Remote sensing gives us a bird's eye view of conditions across the landscape, provides historical snapshot of those conditions, and increases the efficiency of our data collection.
The fourth principle of AIM is electronic data capture and management. The BLM is currently using field tablets and has developed a national AIM database. This enables long-term storage and easy access to data, saving the BLM time and money.
We are doing the AIM strategy on the Rio Grande del Norte National Monument to start in 2014. And what we're looking at is treatment effectiveness of past treatments and to possibly inform new treatments for range monitoring and permit renewals, and to possibly inform ESD development into the future. Right now we only have the old range sites, and so we need some data to inform new ASD development.
In the White River Field Office, we've been using the AIM strategy for 3 years now. We're gathering data to help inform our decisions regarding herd management, range permit renewal decisions, oil and gas reclamation success. And what I really like about AIM is that it's giving us strong, defensible data to use in future resource decisions.
And we're in our second year of AIM on the monument, and we're using it to evaluate land health, the condition of the land in general, not necessarily related to any particular use, but we're using it to hope that we can get a better idea of land conditions so that we can better manage all the uses on the monument and fulfill our mandate of protecting the resources of the monument.
There's also data being collected across all lands to inform us about the condition of the sage-grouse habitat. The next scale is this national scale. where we are collecting in cooperation with the NRCS these core indicators. So what are the status and trends at very large areas across the U.S.? Our interest is in providing information for decision making that helps the BLM sustain the benefits and that the nation receives from the resources we manage. Thank you.